Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. O God, whose property is ever to have mercy and to forgive, we humbly entreat thee for the soul of thy handmaid, which thou hast this day commanded to depart this world. Deliver Caroline and Inoju not into the hands of the enemy.
The Holy Lesson is at the point 27, 1 Thessalonians 4, beginning to read from verse 13. Yet do not have we ignorant brethren, concerning those who are asleep, that you may not be as others who do not have hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep. For this we declare to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, shall not resist those who are falling asleep.
I'd like to commiserate with the idolaters. I must confess that I didn't know the deceased person, but from what I've read and what I've heard, and I think it was yesterday, a nephew of hers was telling me that she was a giver, very generous person. So I want to commiserate with you on the loss of your beloved person. May God grant our rest and grant us grace to rebuild our lives, to live well so that we can die well. The beginning is not important at all. The end is most important. Starting well, ending well. May we all end well in Jesus' name. From the passage just by the family, 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, 13 and 14. But we will not have you ignorant, brethren, concerning those who are asleep. It tells us that a lot of people are ignorant in this world. We call them educated illiterates, especially concerning the things of God. A lot of people, even those who come to church every Sunday, they seem very, very ignorant about the things of God, about the things of heaven. Is the person God? Does he exist at all? How can he be a woman to call the person of Jesus? Is Jesus God? Just like any of the prophets. So a lot of us still have doubts. We still query. We still question the things of God. God should be for those who believe that there is God in first instance, and they don't believe that it can come in the person of Jesus Christ in human form. They still have doubts.
I would like to share this from some of the other It's a piece of poem that David sent to me when her mother came finally to die as a consoling voice. And I think it's like to me to console and to comfort the sister and the other children. In fact, I'm sick. I am free. Don't grieve for me, for now I am free. I'm following the path God gave for me. I took his hand when I heard him talk. I turned my back and let it go. I could not stay another day to laugh, to love, to wept, or pray. The past left alone was stay that way. I found that peace, I found that peace at the close of day. If my counsel has left the world, the spirit will forever join. A friendship shared, a love, a peace. Oh yes, these things I do with this. Do not burden the signs of sorrow. I wish you the sunshine of tomorrow. My life has been full. I have savored much. Good friends, good times, and many loved ones touch. Perhaps my friends seem all too good. Don't let me live now with unclean things. Lift up your hearts and share with me. God wanted me now. He said to me, in those of us, this, let's follow this. God was
there,
God was
there.
Let us
pray. Let us commend our daughter, Father, and your truth to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Heavenly Father, by your mighty power, you gave us life, and in your love, you have given us a new life in Christ Jesus. We entrust Father and you to your merciful keeping in the faith of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who died and rose again to save us and is now alive and raised